Alright, so let's start with the next unit today. This is unit 7 of your class 11, Equilibrium. Now, ये वाला जो chapter है, it has been divided into two sections. One which is known as the chemical equilibrium and the second one which is known as the ionic equilibrium. ठीक है? अब इनमें से आपको जो questions आते हैं, numericals, they are very very simple, they are not very difficult. Especially जब हम लोग chemical equilibrium करेंगे, तो उसमें से numericals जो आपको आएंगे, they are not going to be very very tough. Whether we are talking of your boards, चाहे हम NEET की बात करें या हम JEE mains की बात करें, right? The second part of this, the ionic equilibrium, that is also there are certain set questions, certain set topics जिसमें से हमेशा questions आते हैं, तो we are going to lay a lot of stress on those और ताकि we are able to solve more and more questions, ठीक है? So let's start with this chapter today, which is equilibrium. Unit 7, Equilibrium. So as I just told you that we have categorized this into two different parts. One is the chemical equilibrium, okay, and the second one is ionic. So we are going to start with the first part today, which is chemical equilibrium. Okay? Now whenever it is seen that whenever a reaction is taking place, कोई जरूरी नहीं होता कि entire products जो entire reactants जो हैं या converted into products, ठीक है? Sometimes it so happens that some of the reactants they react to give certain amount of products and the reaction that is you can say मझधार में फंस जाती है या that reaction that is hanging in the middle, which means at that particular time there is going to be both reactants and products which are going to be present in the reaction mixture. ठीक है, now such reactions in which completion of a reaction does not take place, that reaction we say may be a reversible reaction where the when we are taking the reaction towards the forward direction, that is reactants is being converted into products. So at the same time, products will also be converted into reactants. A point comes where the where in the reaction mixture there is sufficient amount of reactants and products which are present, and at that particular time it seems to us that the reaction that has come to a standstill, the reaction is not taking place at all, or we say that the rate of forward reaction that comes or the rate of formation of products that becomes equal to the rate of formation of reactants, usko hum log kya bulate hain, that particular point that is going to be known as equilibrium. Theek hai? So it's again like a game of tug of war in which there are two different teams which are pulling the ropes towards itself, and if you remember ki bachpan mein khela hoga ki rope ke center mein ek hanky baandh dete hain aur usme kya rehta hai ki agar left hand side wala apni taraf ko zyada pull kar raha hai to left hand side wala agar pull karega to kya hoga, that hanky will go towards the left hand side. Then at a similar time the right hand side wali team pull kar rahi hai to hanky will go to the right hand side. Now if both are pulling with the same force, what is going to happen over here, the hanky that stays in the middle, which means that the force applied by both the teams that is going to be same. So that is the point of equilibrium when we are talking of that particular game. Similarly here the point of equilibrium is when the reaction seems to us as a stop still, nothing is happening in the reaction. Okay, an example which we can take over here is that we are mixing hydrogen gas with iodine, right? Now iodine has an intense violet color, we already know that. Okay, so hydrogen is colorless, so initially when we are mixing hydrogen and iodine, in that case the intensity of the color that is going to be maximum because iodine is present in full concentration, hydrogen is also present in full concentration. Slowly and gradually iodine that will start reacting with hydrogen to give us hydrogen iodide, and the intensity of the color that is going to decrease. ठीक है, सो जब इंटेंसिटी कलर की डिक्रीज होती रहेगी, अ पॉइंट विल कम व्हेन देयर इज नो फर्दर चेंज इन कलर, दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. ठीक है, सो लेट्स गो ऑन टू दिस, आई हैव जस्ट गिवन यू एन इंट्रोडक्शन ओवर हियर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू से दैट व्हेनेवर अ स्टेज अपीयर्स व्हेयर नथिंग सीम्स टू बी हैपनिंग इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, दैट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. ठीक है, सो एट दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट the composition of the system that is going to be fixed. So we are saying that the at equilibrium the composition of the system that is going to be fixed. So no change can be seen. So at equilibrium, both the forward and the backward reactions move with equal speeds. Okay? As a result of which, the rate of disappearance of reactants will become exactly equal to the rate of appearance of products. So at equilibrium, rate of disappearance of reactants become equal to rate of appearance of products. And in the reaction mixture, both reactants and products, they are going to be present. Now when we're talking of reactions, we say that there are two types of reactions which are present. One which is known as irreversible reactions. Irreversible reactions, those reactions which proceed in such a manner that the reactant is completely converted into the product. Okay? So reactions which are going to move in only one direction, they are going to be known as irreversible reactions. And these reactions, they are represented by an arrow pointing from the reactants towards the products. Okay? So for example, we have precipitation reactions like BaCl2 plus sodium sulfate. So agar hum in dono ko react karenge, immediately we are going to get a white precipitate of barium sulfate and sodium chloride. Now in this case, once the precipitate has been formed, the reaction cannot be reversed from the product to the reactant side. So this is an example of irreversible reaction. Similarly, if we are heating potassium chlorate, in presence of manganese dioxide. Okay? So, in its presence, if we heat it, it is going to give us KCl plus 3O2. So this is again an irreversible reaction. In a similar manner, if we are decomposing ammonium nitrite on heating, this is going to give us nitrogen plus water. So this is also an irreversible reaction. And even neutralization reactions, like we are taking sodium hydroxide plus HCl. So this is also an irreversible reaction, in which as soon as the alkali or the base and the acid, they are mixed, they are going to produce salt and water. So all these, they are going to be irreversible reactions. Okay? The second type of reactions which we have are known as reversible reactions. So in case of reversible reactions, in which the reaction is taking place in both the directions, that is, the reaction is going forward and at the same time the products, they are reacting to give us the reactants back. Such reactions, they are known as reversible reactions, and such reactions, they are represented by a double arrow. Okay? So that is what reversible reactions are. Now reactions which proceed in both the directions, they never reach to completion. They are going to never reach to completion. So if they are not reaching the completion point, therefore these are the reactions in which equilibrium can be established. Okay? So these are going to be the reactions in which equilibrium that can be established, because the reaction is going from the reactant to the product side, and at the same time it is coming from the product side back to the reactant side. Some of the examples which we can do over here is heating of calcium carbonate to give us calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So this is going to be a reversible reaction. Another example which we can take over here is, another reaction which we can take over here is the combination of H2 plus I2 to give 2HI. Okay, so this is again going to be a reversible reaction. Another example which we can take is the production of ammonia by Haber's process. This is also a reversible reaction. Another reaction we can take is oxidation of sulfur dioxide to give sulfur trioxide. Okay? So all these, they are example of reversible reactions. Now, in case of a chemical equilibrium, what do we understand by the term state of chemical equilibrium? What do you understand by this? Now, the most important characteristic property of any reversible reaction is that it is always going to attain a state of equilibrium. So over here, we are taking one general reaction or a hypothetical reaction, A plus B to give us C plus D. Okay? Now, initially what is going to happen when the reaction begins, only A and B, they are going to be present. There is no C and D present. Okay? So the concentration in the reaction mixture, that is going to be only due to A and only due to B. So initially the rate of forward reaction, that is going to be maximum. Okay, because products are being formed. Now slowly and gradually, what is going to happen, that as soon as the product C and D, they are going to be produced, the backward reaction will start, because C and D, they will connect together or react together to give us back the reactants, which is A and B. Right? Now over here, the rate of forward reaction will keep on decreasing slowly, and the rate of backward reaction, that will keep on increasing slowly. Okay? At time will come when the rate of forward reaction, that becomes equal to the rate of backward reaction, and that is the state of equilibrium, which can be represented by this graph. If you are taking a graph like this, between rate of a reaction and progress of a reaction. Okay? So in this case, as we just said, that the rate of forward reaction, that will keep on decreasing, and the rate of backward reaction, that will keep on increasing. Okay? So at this particular time, both the rates, they become equal. So this is the time at which equilibrium, that is going to be attained. Okay? So progress of the reaction can be taken in terms of time over here. This is the rate of forward reaction, and this is going to be the rate of backward reaction. Okay? So, this wala jo point yahan pe hum dekh rahe hain, when the rate of forward reaction becomes equal to the rate of backward reaction, this is the equilibrium point. Okay? So this is the time at which equilibrium, that is going to be attained. So what are we saying? That at equilibrium, rate of forward reaction, at equilibrium, rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of backward reaction. That is what an equilibrium, that is going to suggest to us. Okay? Now, this wala jo state hai, that is the equilibrium state, it is going to continue indefinitely. Okay? If the conditions such as temperature, concentration and pressure, they are not changed. So, we are not changing the state variables, the state of equilibrium, that is going to exist indefinitely. Okay? Now, at the state of equilibrium, the concentration of the reactants and products in the reaction mixture, they are going to attain the constant value, as we just said, that at equilibrium, number one, rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of backward reaction. Number two, the state exists indefinitely if the state variables, they are not changing. Number three, the composition of the mixture, that is going to be a constant. Okay? So composition of the reaction mixture, that is going to be a constant. Now the state of a reversible reaction, equilibrium ko kaise define kar sakte hain? That the state of a reversible reaction at which the concentration of the reactants and the products do not change with time, that is the state of equilibrium. When the concentration of the reaction mixture or the concentration of the reactants and products do not change with time, that is the state of equilibrium. Theek hai? And finally, it is said that the state of equilibrium is dynamic in nature and not static, which means that it will keep on moving, it does not stop. Okay, it seems to be, when we're looking at the reaction mixture, it seems to us that it has stopped, but it hasn't stopped, it is still moving. The reactants will keep on converting into products, and the same amount of products will keep on converting into reactants. Okay? So it's not static. So let's move on to now the characteristics of equilibrium state. Characteristics of equilibrium state. The first characteristics is that the equilibrium can only be attained in a closed vessel. An example which we can take over here is, or we can say in a closed system. Okay? An example which we can take over here is that if you are decomposing calcium carbonate and we are not taking a closed system over here, in that case the carbon dioxide that will escape in the form of a gas, and hence the reverse reaction that won't be possible. Okay? So always equilibrium can be attained in a closed vessel. Then number two, properties such as pressure, concentration, density or color become constant at equilibrium. They are going to become constant at equilibrium. Okay? Number three, chemical equilibrium can be attained from both sides. Okay? Chemical equilibrium that can be attained from both sides, which means that if we are taking a reaction H2 plus I2 to give 2HI, so we can attain the equilibrium in this direction. At the same time, the equilibrium may also be attained in the reverse direction. Okay? So chahe usko hum forward direction mein bhi attain kar sakte hai aur hum backward direction mein bhi attain kar sakte hai. Jaise, let's say we're taking a graph over here again. We can explain this with the help of a graphical representation. We are taking the graph between concentration and time. Now, initially when the reaction has begun, the reactants in this case, in the first equation, the reactants, they are hydrogen and iodine. So they are going to have maximum concentration, and slowly and gradually the concentration that should keep on decreasing. So let's see that the graph of hydrogen that comes to like this. Okay? At the same time, the graph of iodine will also be like this. Okay? But when we are taking HI over here, in that case HI is the product in the first equation. So initially the concentration of HI, that is going to be zero because there is no HI being formed, and slowly the concentration of HI, that is going to increase. Okay? So at this particular point, we say that if we are drawing a line over here, The concentration of H2 is becoming constant, the concentration of I2 is becoming constant, and the concentration of HI is also becoming constant. So this is the time where equilibrium will be attained. Now we are dividing this graph into two different regions. ठीक है? जहाँ पे change हो रहा है reactants और products में, उसको हम लोग kinetic region बुलाते हैं. That is known as the kinetic region. And after when the concentration that is not changing at all, then that is known as what? That is known as the equilibrium region. So you can see over here that whether we are trying to calculate the equilibrium with respect to hydrogen and iodide, or we are trying to calculate the equilibrium with respect to HI, in both the cases the time of equilibrium that is going to be same. So you can calculate the equilibrium by the forward reaction or forward direction of the reaction, and at the same time we can do it in the backward. Okay, so this is the third characteristics. Fourth characteristics is that the equilibrium can be attained in a shorter time. Equilibrium can be attained in a shorter time by use of a positive catalyst. Right? Although catalyst that is not going to change the position of the equilibrium state, but it will help us to attain equilibrium rapidly. ठीक है? जल्दी equilibrium को हम attain कर सकते हैं by using a catalyst, although it will not change the position of the equilibrium. Okay? Then next is, we've just done it, that it is not static, but it is going to be dynamic in nature. Okay, so these are going to be the characteristics of equilibrium state. Then next we go on to the two types of reversible reactions which we are going to study over here. So we are going on to the types of reversible reactions. It is seen that there are two types of reversible reactions, one which are known as heterogeneous reactions. Heterogeneous reactions. In case of heterogeneous reactions, the reversible reaction in which more than one phase is going to be present, that is heterogeneous. For example, if we are taking the decomposition of calcium carbonate, which is a solid, when heated, give us calcium oxide, which is a solid, but carbon dioxide, which is a ball, that is a gas. So this is an example of heterogeneous system. Okay, heterogeneous reversible reaction. In a similar manner, we can take the decomposition of magnesium carbonate. Okay, so this is going to give us magnesium oxide, which is solid, and again carbon dioxide, which is a gas. The second type of reversible reactions which we have, they are homogeneous. Homogeneous reactions. In homogeneous, the reactants and products, they are present in the same phase. For example, if we have N2 plus 3 H2, this is gaseous, this is gaseous, this is going to give us 2NH3, which is again gaseous. Okay? So this is homogeneous, in which both are present. Now homogeneous reversible reactions may be of the following types further. Number one, types of homogeneous reactions we are doing over here. The first one is when there is no change in number of molecules of the reactants in products. That is, in this case, delta N, that is going to be equal to 0. There is going to be no change in number of moles of reactants and products. For example, we are taking hydrogen and iodine in the gaseous state, and this is going to give us
2HI gaseous.
So in this case, you can see that number of moles of the products is equal to the number of moles of the reactants. Okay? In a similar manner, we can take the decomposition of nitric oxide. All are in the gaseous form. So again, number of reactants is going to be equal to the number of products. Okay? Second is when the number of moles of products is more than the number of mole of reactants. Or in other words, we are saying over here that delta N is greater than 0 or it is equal to positive. Right? An example which we can take over here is the decomposition of PCl5 to PCl3 plus Cl2. Okay? Another example which we can take over here is the decomposition of ammonia into N2 plus 3H2. So you can see over here that the number of moles of the products, they are greater than the number of moles of the reactants. Then in the third case, when there is a decrease in number of moles, or in other words, we can say that the value of delta N, that is going to be negative. An example which we can take over here is a reverse reaction of this what we've taken over here. That is the production of ammonia by Haber's process. So we have 2NH3. Okay? Also we can take another example. That is the oxidation of sulfur dioxide to give sulfur trioxide. Right? So these are the three types of reactions. Why we are doing all this is because this will help us to calculate the value of the equilibrium constant, which we will come to in the coming sections. Okay? So you need to remember that whenever delta N is equal to 0, number of moles of reactants become equal to the number of molar products. If delta N is positive, number of moles of the products is going to be greater than the number of moles of reactants. And if delta N is negative, the number of moles of reactants, that is going to be greater than the number of moles of products. Right? So let's go on to the law of chemical equilibrium. Chemical equilibrium, that is applications of law of mass action. Application of law of mass action. Now we know that what is law of mass action first of all. Law of mass action states that the rate of any reaction, rate of any reaction that is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactants. That is what law of mass action states. Okay? So now if we are taking a hypothetical reaction over here, A plus B to give us C plus D. Okay? Now in this case, what are we saying? That if we are taking, we know that rate can be taken in a reversible reaction from both the sides. Okay? So we are now first considering the rate of forward reaction. So in case of rate of forward reaction, according to the law of mass action, that will be directly proportional to concentration of B, A into concentration of B. Okay? Or Rf, that is equal to Kf into concentration of A, concentration of B. Okay? Now Kf over here is a constant which is known as rate constant. It may also be known as velocity constant. Okay? और जो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन होती है जो हम लोगों ने स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट से यहाँ पे ली है दैट इज नोन एज द एक्टिव मासेस. सो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ए इनटू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ बी. सो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ए मींस एक्टिव मास ऑफ ए एंड कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ बी मींस एक्टिव मास ऑफ बी. सो दिस इज अनदर नेम और नॉमेनक्लेचर व्हिच इज जनरली यूज्ड फॉर कॉन्सेंट्रेशंस. ठीक है, अभी आ गया हमारा रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन. व्हाट हैपेंस टू द रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन? वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड इन दिस मैनर. सो रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन शुड बी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ active masses of C and D. Okay? Or rate of backward reaction that becomes equal to KB, concentration of C into concentration of B. Again, where KB, that is going to be equal to rate constant for the backward reaction. Now, at equilibrium, Okay, so let's put the values, rate of forward reaction, that is Kf into concentration of A into concentration of B, that is equal to Kb into concentration of C into concentration of D. Okay, getting the like terms together, what will we have? Kf upon Kb, that is equal to concentration of C into concentration of D upon concentration of A into concentration of B. ठीक है, अब ये जो Kf upon Kb हम लोग ले रहे हैं, this is going to be a constant which is denoted by capital K, which is known as the equilibrium constant for a reaction. So we can say that the equilibrium constant K, that is equal to the product of concentration of products upon the product of concentration of reactants. Now if in case there is stoichiometry which is involved over here, we have A, A, B, B, C, C, D, D. So that will go in the form of powers over here. So we have C raised to power C, D raised to power D, A raised to power A and B raised to power B. Okay? So this is how you are going to put it. So now we say that when we are looking at K over here, because we are considering the concentrations, so this can be represented as Kc. Kc has a definite value of every reaction at any particular temperature, irrespective of the concentrations. Okay? Just say for example, if you are taking a reaction H2 plus I2 to give 2HI, the equilibrium constant for this, that will always get a value of 48. Okay, so 48 is a set value at the same temperature. Temperature should be fixed over here, irrespective of the fact how much amount of hydrogen and iodine we are taking when we have started the reaction. Okay, so K is going to have a constant value at a given temperature. So how do we now define the equilibrium constant which we have placed over here? What is equilibrium constant? It is the ratio between the concentrations of the products to the molar concentration of the reactants, with each concentration term raised to the power equal to the stoichiometric coefficient in the balanced chemical equation. So that is how you are going to define equilibrium constant C. Now the value of equilibrium constant, that is going to be independent of the following factors. So what are we saying over here? We are saying that the value of equilibrium constant is independent of the value, independent of the following factors. Number one, initial concentration of the reactants. Initial concentration of the reactants. Number two, presence of a catalyst. So all these things, they are not going to affect. Presence of a catalyst. Number three, direction from which the equilibrium is attained. We have just studied that we can derive the value of equilibrium constant in both the directions, forward and backward. Okay? And number four, presence of inert atmosphere. So all these factors, they are not going to affect the equilibrium. So what are the factors which will now affect the equilibrium? Factors affecting the value of equilibrium constant K. What are these factors? Number one, mode of representation of the reaction. This is one section from which you get questions, so just understand this very carefully. Mode of representation of a reaction. Okay, now if in case we are taking reaction A plus B to give us C plus D. In this case, the value of Kc, as we have just derived, will be given as concentration of C into concentration of B upon concentration of A into concentration of B. ठीक है, ये हमारे पास आ गया. Now, if the products they are made the reactants, then what is going to happen? So, which means now we are going to attain the equilibrium from the reverse side. ठीक है, so अगर हमारे पास reaction इस तरह से आ रही है, A plus B, then what is going to be the value of the new equilibrium constant K dash? That is going to be equal to concentration of A into concentration of B upon concentration of C into concentration of D, right? So which means that the new value of equilibrium constant K dash, that is going to be equal to the reversal of the old value, which is K. Is it clear? So this is very, very important, that if the reaction is reversed, the value of new equilibrium constant, that will become equal to the reciprocal of the initial equilibrium value ki, kya kehte hai usko, numerical value. Is it clear? So, agar humne wo H2 plus I2 ka 2HI ka 48 liya tha, to reverse reaction karenge, to kya jayega? 1 upon 48. Got it? Second is stoichiometric representation. This is again very, very important. Stoichiometric representation. ठीक है? Now, in this case, we are saying, number one, that if we are dividing the equation by two, if we divide the equation by two, then in that case, the value, the new value of equilibrium constant K dash, that becomes equal to under root of K. Very, very important. ठीक है, तो आपको इसमें क्वेश्चन ऐसे दे रखा होता है कि दे गिवन यू अ रिएक्शन एंड दे आर सेइंग कि ओके नाउ द रिएक्शन इज गोइंग टू बी दिस. ओके, सो दे हैव डिवाइडेड द रिएक्शन बाय 2 एंड दे से कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम, न्यू इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट, देन दैट विल बी इक्वल टू के डैश इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ के. सो अगर हम वही वाली रिएक्शन ले रहे हैं जिसमें हमने 48 लिया था, तो न्यू के डैश दैट विल बी इक्वल टू व्हाट? अंडर रूट ऑफ 48. ठीक है, नंबर 2, इफ वी मल्टीप्लाई the equation by 2. Okay, so if we are multiplying the equation by 2, in that case, K dash, that will become equal to K ka square. ठीक है? If we are multiplying the equation by 2, then the new equilibrium constant will have a value of square of the initial value of equilibrium constant. Number 3, if the reaction is taking place in more than one steps, okay? Like for example, we are saying over here that we are taking any reaction which is taking place in two different steps, right? Okay, we are saying that we are taking a reaction over here, N2 plus O2 plus Cl2. This is giving us 2NOCl. So we are looking at the value of K over here. The value of K, that will be equal to concentration of NOCl ka square upon concentration of N2 into concentration of O2 into concentration of Cl2. ठीक है? Now in this case, suppose the above equation that is taking place in two different steps. In the first step, we have N2 plus O2 to give 2NO2. And in the second step, 2NO2 plus Cl2 to give us 2NOCl. Let's say that the equilibrium constant for this, that is equal to K1. And the equilibrium constant for this, that is equal to K2. Okay? Then the total equilibrium constant K, that will be equal to K1 into K2. Okay? Okay, so these are the things which you need to remember in this case, and definitely we expect one question from this particular section. So today we are going to do only till here.